Yo, new day, new era, new year, new me, even though I'm still gonna be a hoe. Told y'all niggas, man, we changing the whole vibe of this shit. We changing the whole vibe. This is Kingknown of Uncensored, episode one. We're gonna do a little bit of NBA talk. I ain't got a title for this. You'll see the title when it drops. And we just gonna hop right into it, man. Fuck that introduction shit. Straight up. Fuck it, we on now. But anyway, Michael Porter Jr. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about the boy MPJ. He's had a hell of a yesterday against the Indiana Pacers, where the Denver Nuggets won the game. He was a plus 8 on the floor. He had 25 points and 5 rebounds. We are seeing what we saw in Missouri with this kid. And I kind of knew that he was going to be the real deal. And I knew that if he came back and he was half of what he was in college, the world needs to look out. Straight up. The world needs to fucking look out. I told people that if Denver were to, you know, get a score, like somebody that could possibly average 20 points per game, and that's what Porter Jr. is. I just think that Mike Malone needs to play him a little bit more. And I believe that he will flourish. And just shout out to Michael Porter Jr. I watched the third and fourth quarter yesterday, and I just seen Michael Porter Jr. hitting a Bentley of shots, finishing at the rim, has a nice little step back. Defense could use a little bit more improvement, in my opinion. But yeah, Michael Porter Jr. is everything that I thought he was going to be. Now all Denver has to do is get baby Manute back, and it's on and cracking after that. Anyway, on to Carmelo Anthony. He is on a tear. This season, he's averaging 16-6 per game as a third option. Well, I don't know. He might be a fourth because of Whiteside. Carmelo Anthony, in his last game against New York had 26. Tonight against the Wizards. Let me take a look at that game real quick. I heard he had another good game tonight. I didn't watch the game, unfortunately. I was watching, the Rockets and the Sixers game. Portland won 122-103. Let's check the box score on these hoes. All right, Carmelo Anthony had 16 and was 7 of 9 from the field. Hassan Whiteside, 23 points. CJ McCollum, 24 points. Dame Lillard, 35 points on 10 of 20 shooting. Shit. Hassan Whiteside had 21 rebounds and 23 points. If you're asking me, do I think that Portland should trade him? Hell no. But since we're on the subject, before this game against Washington, obviously, I felt like the Trailblazers were in trouble because they were dropping games that I felt like they should have won. I mean, they're dropping doo-doo crumbs. If you look at the NBA standings right now, the Trailblazers are a half game back from the eighth spot, which the Spurs currently occupy. Their last 10, both teams are 5-5, so it will be interesting to see if the Blazers can get their shit together. Because, I mean, you get about 3-4 games behind, you're going to lose your spot. I mean, 1-7 is pretty much a sealed fate here. I mean, as the Thunder have improved all around as a team this season, despite Danilo Gallinari being on the trading block. Now, let's move on to Darren Collison. Darren Collison shocked the world last 2 months ago by retiring. And now, I think that was the end of last season. I don't fucking remember. But anyway, he shocked the world by retiring, and now he wants to eye an NBA return, and he wants to join either the Lakers or the Clippers. Now, if you're asking me who needs him more, I believe the Lakers need him more because he could slip in and be the starting point guard for the LA Lakers. Darren Collison could pretty much do a lot of things. He got a decent three-point shot. He's a great distributor, and that way LeBron James doesn't have to bring up the ball all the time. But at the same time, regardless, they're probably, knowing him, they're probably going to make him a spot-up shooter like they did Mario Chalmers when he was with the Miami Heat, instead of letting him do what the fuck a point guard does. So I don't know. I think the Lakers definitely need him more. I think the Clippers are good at guard. I think the Clippers need big men, you know, that can stand up there with McGee and Howard and possibly the return of Boogie Cousins. I'm currently watching the Lakers play the Pelicans now, even though I'm not going to be watching very long. But anyway, Andre Iguodala, let's move on to him. The Memphis Grizzlies are guaranteed to trade Iguodala. Now, me, the best fit for Andre Iguodala is the Denver Nuggets. I don't see a problem with them flipping Gary Harris straight up for Iguodala. Gary Harris in a first-round pick, because that's what the Grizzlies want, is a first-round pick from somebody for Iguodala. And, you know, as far as I'm concerned, I believe that the Memphis Grizzlies should make that deal, because Gary Harris and Ja Morant would be a great backcourt for them. In my opinion, I think that that would be like a really good backcourt for that team. It would be very interesting to see. And with Iguodala going to Denver, that's the last piece that they need. And I think that they punched their ticket to the NBA Finals. I think that if they add Iguodala, that is the last piece right there. Now, I think that they're going to move Barton as to the shooting guard and maybe even consider starting Iguodala. So, there are a lot of teams that are obviously interested in Andre Iguodala. And the favorites to land Iguodala, according to fadeawayworld.net, the Mavericks are reportedly the favorites to land Andre Iguodala. Dallas could possibly project to get the Golden State Warriors 2020 second rounder from the Andrew Bogut trade, which could end up being the 31st overall selection. This could be a key asset in the bidding war for Iguodala. One Western Conference executive called the Stein Report posturing, saying they're probably arguing over the Warriors pick. Who else is in pursuit of Iguodala via trade is unclear. Now, me personally, the team that I believe should get Iguodala is Denver. The LA Clippers, obviously. I mean, come on. That would be, that would, like, I've been saying this on Kingknown Talking Shit, right? That Iguodala, whoever lands him, could possibly punch their ticket to the finals. Because Iguodala is the one piece that, the last piece that a lot of teams need. If he goes to the Rockets, I would lean towards Houston over the Lakers and the Clippers for the finals. It's, I mean, because we all know that he's landing west. If he lands east, I don't know. But whoever can land him in the Western Conference, who is currently like 1 through 6 or 1 through 5, I should say. Even if Utah lands Iguodala, it could get them out the first round. But I don't know about second round. You know what I'm saying? So, me personally, the destination, the ideal destination for Iggy should be Denver. And regardless of what, you know, Iguodala does, he's going back to Golden State next season. So you got him for a 1-year rental. So Iguodala, obviously the 3-time champion and the finals MVP, wants to go to a championship contending team. Paul George is injured again. And he has a pulled hamstring. This is a blow to the Clippers, especially with Kawhi doing the load management thing. It could possibly, the Clippers could possibly go from maybe the 3rd seed to a 5th seed. And they could get somebody difficult like the Rockets in the first round. I don't want Denver or Houston in the playoffs in the first round, because that would be very difficult. But I believe that the Clippers would win that series, but it would be a hard-fought, hard-nosed 7-game series. So, Andre Drummond is on the trading block. It's about goddamn time. Me, as a Pistons fan, the Andre Drummond experiment has failed. Let's look at the, ever since Andre Drummond got into the league, let's look at the years that Drummond has been in the league. Now, Andre Drummond is one of the more superior rebounders in the game, but he's not known for anything else. Offensively, he's pretty much limited. He doesn't have a post game. He doesn't finish over other centers well. Pause. And he's just a lump of crap. He's a guy who was drafted to be the next Dwight Howard and ended up being just a role player who could get you 16 and 17, which is cute numbers and everything, but he's not a franchise guy. He's more of a third option on a contending team. He couldn't lead a franchise to anything. That's just my opinion. He's been somewhat of a disappointment, in my opinion. I mean, if you look at the 2 years that Andre Drummond has been in the league, I mean, the seasons that Drummond has been in the league, he's posted an 0-8 playoff record with the teams that were put and built around him. They lost in the first round to the Cavaliers in a sweep, and then they lost to the Milwaukee Bucks last year. And now currently they stand 11th in the Eastern Conference, which is very fucking disappointing as a Pistons fan. So, I mean, me personally, been a long time coming. Now, the teams that want Andre Drummond, one of them is the Atlanta Hawks. That makes a lot of sense. Now, let's go to the lean, mean trade machine and see what we can come up with. And so, A trade that I would like them to do, me personally, this trade I would like the Detroit Pistons to do to get is I would propose Allen Crabbe, Cam Reddish, and John Collins in a first-round pick for Andre Drummond. A Hawks next year pick. That would be a good trade because we get John Collins and Blake Griffin, but the only problem is who's going to play center. You know, these are two guys that do some of the same things, and I believe that if this trade goes down, then Blake Griffin is probably going to be out of there too. Honestly, they should trade Drummond and Blake. Fuck it. Why not? Clean house. And I think that they should keep Reggie Jackson because of the contract. The contract is $17 million off the books next season. That way, we can sign role players because there is no marquee free agent that is going to come to Detroit unless they're born and raised in Detroit. I mean, let's be honest here. I mean, and then the Dallas Mavericks, who I have said on multiple occasions that they want Drummond as well. And I'm not surprised because of the simple fact that I feel like Luka, Kristaps, and Drummond would be a big three, so to speak. Now let's see what can Detroit get out of Dallas here by the lean mean trade machine. I mean, obviously we can get the Courtney Lee contract because that shit expires. I mean, DeLon Wright's a decent backup point guard. Could help us. They're not going to come up off of Tim Hardaway Jr. They like him too much. And maybe, I don't know, maybe Boban back because they for damn sure don't play him. They don't play Boban Marjanovic enough. And then maybe a pick. So, Courtney Lee, DeLon Wright, and Boban Marjanovic for Andre Drummond, you know, and it's a legal trade. You know, obviously, we would get some picks because, you know, unfortunately, Drummond was perceived as a franchise player when in all reality, he's an overpaid role player who can get you 15 and 15. It's just the facts. There are a lot of teams that are inquiring about Kyle Kuzma. Now, Kyle Kuzma and LeBron James, I don't know if you watched the last show, but Kyle Kuzma's trainer called out LeBron James and said that he ain't been in the gym, they ain't been practicing, and Kyle Kuzma has been in the gym. And, you know, Kuzma led the team in scoring against the Clippers, and I guess the trainer said that LeBron didn't want any smoke with Kawhi, which is pretty much facts, because I didn't see him checking him. Kawhi checked up on him, though. But a lot of teams are eyeing Kyle Kuzma, even though the Lakers want to keep him, obviously, because he brings a certain thing to the team off the bench, a certain punch. You know, him scoring that 23 points changed their mind. Now, I believe that the Lakers should go and sign Darren Collison. And then Frank Vogel says that DeMarcus Cousins is progressing to light jogging and is still a possibility to return at some point this season. If Boogie is at least 50%, that could be a problem for a lot of teams that are trying to match up with them. And I think if DeMarcus Cousins does return before the trade deadline, I believe the Clippers are going to make a move and go get a big man. Because with every big move that somebody makes, there are other teams looking to make big moves too. According to Shams Charania of The Athletic, who, along with Woj, is the two cats that always bring out the great reports. I mean, Kuzma's only averaging 12 points per game while shooting 35% from three, which is not Kuzma-like. Now, over the last five games, Kuzma has put up 17 points per game and hitting 41% of his shots and only 32% from three-point range. I guess they're not reporting who is inquiring about Kuzma yet, but I am pretty sure that it will be interesting to see. That's pretty much my show, my first show, man. Kingknown, Uncensored. And oh yeah, please subscribe to me on Patreon. Kingknown NBA and Music Talk. And you can join the Uncensored Money and, donate $1 a month. You can subscribe for $1 a month. And there are other tiers to join as well if you want to support the page and whatnot. And obviously, as you can see on my YouTube, I changed my YouTube name. It's to be a little bit more professional. Nothing more. So if you want to follow me on Twitter, at Kingknown on Twitter. If you want to follow me on Instagram, it's Kingknown on Instagram and Quentin Cleary on Facebook and Kingknown NBA and Music Talk on YouTube. Thank you very much for watching. And I'm out this bitch.